In this video, I'll show you how to deploy a hyper-converged architecture. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager has been integrated with Gluster 6, an open-source distributed file system, to provide a hyper-converged solution where both compute and storage are provided from the same host. Gluster volumes residing on the host are used as storage domains in the manager to store the virtual machine images. Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager is run as a self-hosted engine within a virtual machine on these hosts. To deploy this hyper-converged solution, you must satisfy the following prerequisites. There must be a minimum of 3 Oracle Linux 7 servers with minimal installation. Currently, this configuration is supported with Oracle Linux 7 only. The minimal release is the same as specified in Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager documentation. For this demonstration, I'll call my 3 Oracle Linux 7 servers a.us.oracle.com, b.us.oracle.com, and c.us.oracle.com. These 3 systems are physical servers on the Oracle network. Host A is a Netra server, X5-2, and host B and C are Oracle server, X5-2. Host A will be our deployment host. That is, I'll initiate the deployment from host A. Ensure that the Firewall D service is enabled and started on all 3 Oracle Linux 7 servers. If you are using a proxy server for internet access, configure YUM with the proxy server settings. You must have configured passwordless SSH between the first server to itself and to the other 2 servers. This is needed for Gluster deployment. The fully qualified domain names of the 3 Oracle Linux servers can be resolved using DNS or through the /etc/host file on the servers. Continuing on with the prerequisites, you must have a fully qualified domain name prepared for your self-hosted engine. For this demonstration, I'll call my self-hosted engine book.us.oracle.com. Forward and reverse lookup records must be set in the DNS, and the self-hosted engine should use the same subnet as the management network. Install the required software packages. On all 3 hosts, install the oracle-overt-release-el7 package. This package is provided by the ol7_latest YUM repository. Install the cockpit-overt-dashboard package. This provides a UI for the installation. And install the vdsm-gluster package. This is a plugin to manage Gluster services. Both the cockpit-overt-dashboard package and the vdsm-gluster package are provided by the overt-4.3 YUM repository. On the deployment host only, install the following packages: overt-engine-appliance. This is for the engine virtual machine installation. This package is provided by overt-4.3 YUM repository. And gluster-ansible-roles. This is for deploying, configuring, and maintaining GlusterFS clusters, and is provided by the ol7_gluster6 YUM repository. Set up the hyper-converged environment. On the deployment host, start the cockpit service and enable cockpit on Firewall D by running the commands shown: systemctl enable --now cockpit, firewall-cmd --permanent --add-service equals cockpit, and then firewall-cmd --reload. From a web browser, log in to the cockpit management interface of your Oracle Linux 7 deployment host at port 9090. In this demonstration, host a.us.oracle.com is our deployment host. From the cockpit UI on the deployment host, start the deployment wizard by clicking Virtualization, then Hosted Manager, then click the Start button under Hyper-Converged. We'll now begin the demonstration portion of this video. I've accessed the cockpit management interface on our deployment host A at port 9090. I'll log in as root and provide the root password. Now I'll start the deployment wizard by clicking the V in the left-hand menu for virtualization. Then I'll click Hosted Manager. Then I'll scroll down and click the Start button under Hyper-Converged. This allows us to configure Gluster storage, which is the first step in this deployment. An existing Gluster configuration exists, so I'm going to click the Clean Existing Gluster Deployment button. This deletes the volumes, removes the brick directories, unmounts the disk, wipes the file system from the logical volumes, deletes the volume groups, removes the physical volumes, and performs a number of other cleanup tasks. We'll see later in this demonstration that we select /dev/sdb as the device to be used to create the Gluster brick. but I've logged on to our host A to show that /dev/sdb is clean and available for use. Now I'll click the Run Gluster Wizard button, and I'm first asked to provide the Gluster host. I'll enter our three Oracle Linux 7 servers, a.us.oracle.com, b.us.oracle.com, and c.us.oracle.com. As you have noticed, I'm masking out the full host names for security purposes. I'll click Next, and for the additional host, I'll click the Use Same Host Names as in Previous Step checkbox. I'll click Next, and for the Packages window, no entries are required since we already installed the required packages. Additional packages can optionally be installed on all hosts, but I'll click Next for this demonstration. On the Volumes window, you define the Gluster volumes that need to be created. These Gluster volumes will be used later in the wizard to create storage domains in Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager. Three Gluster volumes are defined by default. The first volume in the list, named Engine, is used to host the hosted engine virtual disk. The second volume, named Data, is used to host the data disk of the virtual machines. And the third volume, named VM Store, is used to host the OS disk of the virtual machines. Separating the volumes as shown eases backup, assuming only the data volume will need to be backed up. All three Gluster volumes will be created as data storage domains. I'll click Next to move to the Bricks tab. Here you configure the devices to use for the Gluster volumes defined in the previous step. If the devices used for Bricks are configured as RAID devices, provide the information in the RAID information section. I'll just take the defaults and scroll down to the Brick configuration section. Brick configuration allows for per host definition of bricks. This is useful in case the device names are not uniform across the host. I'm going to use /dev/sdb for creating Gluster volumes. The only change I'll make here is to change the default size of 500 GB for data in VM Store to 200 GB. I'll click Next, and from here you can review the generated Ansible inventory and deploy Gluster. I'm going to click the Enable Debug Logging checkbox just in case the deployment fails. I'll have more information for troubleshooting. Now I'll click the Deploy button. In this demonstration, the deployment takes a couple of minutes, but I'll speed through this. Gluster is successfully deployed. I'll log into our three Oracle Linux 7 hosts and view the configuration on /dev/sdb. Here is the Gluster configuration on host A. We used /dev/sdb on all hosts for creating Gluster volumes. So here is the configuration on host B, and here is the Gluster volume configuration on host C. Once Gluster deployment is finished, click the Continue to Hosted Engine Deployment button to begin configuring your hosted engine. This results in Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager running as a virtual machine on the first physical machine in your deployment. In this VM window, provide the Engine VM FQDN. Recall from the prerequisites mentioned earlier in this video, you must have prepared a fully qualified domain name for your self-hosted engine. For this demonstration, I created a DNS entry for my self-hosted engine named book.us.oracle.com. I'm also going to change the network configuration from the default of DHCP to static and provide the IP addresses for the VM, the gateway, and the DNS server. I'm going to provide the root password and take the remaining defaults for the VM settings. I'll scroll down and click Advanced to view more settings. The only thing I'll change here is to use ping for the network test rather than the default of DNS. I'll click Next. On the engine window, I'll provide an admin portal password and keep the remaining defaults. I'll click Next, and I'm presented with an opportunity to review the configuration. You can click back and make changes if you need to. The configuration looks good to me, so I'll scroll down and click Prepare VM. This will create a local hosted engine VM. In this demonstration, it took about 20 minutes to prepare the hosted engine VM, but I'll speed through this. Execution completed successfully. I'll click Next to configure the storage domain that will be used to host the self-hosted engine disk. The only change I'll make here is under the Advanced settings. I'll increase the disk size to 80 GB. I'll click Next. You can now review the configuration and go back if any changes are needed. I'll click the Finish Deployment button. Now the local self-hosted engine will be transferred to the configured Gluster storage domain. In this demonstration, it took about 14 minutes to finish the deployment, but I'll speed through this. The hosted engine deployment completed. I'll click the close button, and now I can exit this cockpit management interface. Now we can access the self-hosted engine. I'll browse to book.us.oracle.com/overt-engine and log into the administration portal. The dashboard shows we have 3 hosts, 3 data storage domains, 3 cluster volumes, and 1 virtual machine. I'll view our 3 Oracle Linux 7 hosts. I'll view our 3 GlusterFS storage domains. I'll view our 3 Gluster volumes. And I'll view our 1 hosted engine virtual machine. This concludes the demonstration portion of this video. For more information, you can refer to the Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager Getting Started Guide, the Upstream Overt documentation, the GlusterFS documentation, and the Oracle Communities page on deploying Oracle Linux Virtualization Manager and Gluster Hyper-Converged. This concludes this video. Thank you for watching.